Hey there, I'm Sophia, and I'm going to walk you through how to inject delestrogen into your muscle, or intramuscularly. This method helps the medication absorb into the bloodstream more quickly. These instructions are broken up into 5 quick steps. Let's start by making sure you've got all your supplies ready to go. A multiple dose vial of delestrogen, also known as estradiol valerate, at room temp, a syringe, a drawing needle, an injection needle, plus alcohol pads, sterile gauze, a sharps container, and a clean surface. You may get prescriptions or supplies that use CC or ML interchangeably. Don't worry. They're just different names for the same amount of volume. For example, 1 CC is equal to 1 ml. Now, go ahead and wash your hands really well with soap and water. Then you're on to preparing the syringe. If you're using the vial for the first time, go ahead and remove the cap and wipe the top of the vial with an alcohol swab. Just remember to repeat this step every time you reuse a vial. Also, if the solution isn't clear or you see any particles floating around, don't use it and call your healthcare provider right away for next steps. Make sure your medication is at room temp. If it's cold, you may see crystals, but they'll disappear once it warms up. Next, unwrap the syringe and drawing needle. And twist the needle onto the syringe. Then, remove the needle cap. Draw air into the syringe by pulling back the plunger to the ml or cc marking that matches your dose. Place the vial on a flat surface and insert the needle through the rubber stopper and into the vial. Gently press the plunger all the way in, which pushes the air into the vial and makes it easier to withdraw. Without removing the needle, turn the vial upside down. Make sure the tip of the needle stays submerged in the solution as you slowly pull back the plunger to withdraw your dose. You'll only be using a portion of medication for every injection, so it's really important to double-check and give yourself the right dose, not the entire vial. Go ahead and remove the needle and syringe from the vial, and replace the cap. Now you're ready to switch needles, so twist the drawing needle off the syringe and toss it into the sharps container. Then remove the wrapper from the long injection needle. Twist that needle onto the syringe and pull off the needle cap. Point the needle up and tap or flick the syringe to remove any air bubbles, or until the bubbles rise to the top. Then press the plunger slightly until a tiny droplet of medication appears at the tip of the needle. A droplet is a good thing. It means your medication is ready to go. Recap the injection needle and set it aside. Now you're ready to move on to preparing your injection area.
There are a few places where you can inject your medication into the muscle. For today, I'll show you how to inject into your butt. You might find it's helpful to have someone else administer the injection. But if you're planning to do it yourself, use a mirror so it's easier to see what's going on back there.
To start, select a location that's within the upper, outer quadrant of either side of your butt.
Keep track of which side you inject, since you'll switch sides each day. And never inject into an area that's tender, red, bruised, or hard. Giving yourself a shot in the muscle can be a bit uncomfortable. So before you start, apply ice or a frozen bag of veggies for a few minutes to numb the area. You might also find it helpful to put the syringe, without the needle inserted, inside your bra or under your arm to warm it up.
When you're ready, use an alcohol wipe to clean the skin, about 2 inches around the injection area. Then give it a couple of seconds to dry. Now you're ready to inject the medication. So let's do it. Remove the needle cap and hold the syringe with one hand. Then use the thumb and index finger from your other hand to firmly stretch the skin around the injection area. Using a quick, dart-like motion, insert the entire needle straight into the skin at a 90-degree angle. Then, hold the syringe and gently pull back on the plunger just a little bit and look for blood in the syringe.
This doesn't happen often, but if you do see blood in the syringe, do not inject the medication. Instead, withdraw the needle right away. Cover the area with a gauze pad and apply pressure. Toss the syringe and needle into the sharps container and start over. If there's no blood in the syringe, keep going and slowly push the plunger to inject all of the medication. Do a quick count of 1, 2, 3. Press down firmly on the injection area with a gauze pad and remove the needle. And you did it! Nice job! Now your final step is cleanup. If there's delestrogen left in the vial, replace the cap and store in a safe place at room temp for up to 28 days. Then toss the used syringe and needles into the sharps container. And that's it. Thanks so much for watching today. Take care.